kind of how I think about it. But yeah, absolutely.
What about the return?
Quick.
But where is it coming from? Top hand? Like you now to throw the frisbee?
We'll talk about that
okay.
out there.
Okay.
We worked on that at the end of the day.
Okay.
Because you guys are coming out to the side a little bit and you're tense.
That's not necessarily what the club teaches.
Okay. Because you guys were talking that you're taught this,
that,
right?
We want the Kavika wants to pull it out of the sheet, come straight up, not
yeah.
flare. He doesn't want us to flare. That's the novice.
I mean, straight forward is good.
Okay.
Right? The reason the teacher goes straight forward is because that's the closest distance to get to the front.
Okay.
Takes less time. But, I mean, from Gerard, they're not teaching up. He teaches close. So wrist breaks.
Wow.
In, load, wrist breaks.
So small. Keeping it small.
Because this is energy.
Right.
And they come out like this. They don't come out like this. Right. That's why you see that little flip of water
and
sometimes.
I was noticing the water flip.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, I bitch about that constantly.
That's the wrist. They roll the wrist and it just kind of gets a little water off it.
Okay.
That's no big deal.
Yeah.
And this is, I mean, like I said, we shouldn't really even have the wheel. We look at all the things we're doing right now. That's what I do.
Okay.
Anyway, so. Let me see. That little kind of quicker in the back I don't like. But it's not that. Who's in two?
Right.
Okay, so your load is there, right? And it's normal to reach farther than you put the paddle in. Top hand's going forward a little early. That's why you're losing the angle, but his hand stays back a little bit, so we can complain about that at the moment. But your load is at a nice angle. So like I said, if I watch your top hand, it's slow until the second part of the stroke, right? Or the end, and that's because you're rolling your knuckle. Load, 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 this knuckle rolls forward, gets quick, right? So you keep the knuckle back a little longer, could slow it down. You have a habit of trying to be a little bit kicky in the back. Both of you guys a little bit quick in the back, which I think should be slower. But nice, you know, blades out, load is there. And like I said, I look at top hand speed, which was good, especially for the first part of the stroke. And then I look at where the blade is loaded, and yours is there, right? Yeah, right there. And it's at a forward angle. You should, if somebody's loading, you can call it bottom hand in front of the top. I look more at the paddle angle, you know, top to bottom. If you're loading back angle, not so good. If you're loading straight up and down, usually I'll let that slide and tell you to work on it. If you're loading forward, it's okay. You've got water, you're grabbing water. I mean, that's really what the important thing is. Timing is not so great just because he's got some things going on. You guys can work on that. Like timing of the angles of the blade, right? It's because of that bent top arm. Okay, so he's real deep in the water, and I like how he's relaxed in the back.
Fit well, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know, he's solid, he's deep, mechanics are nice, and the back is relaxed. There's no jerkiness, there's no tension back there. It's letting the boat go to me. Right, so I like that. Knuckles are rolling forward a little bit. We can teach him to push down more and he'll get more power. Right, you reach here, your blade's loaded there. Top hand rolls forward a little bit and loses an angle a little bit, but it's okay, it's not bad. You know, if your bottom hand gets wet when you're learning, you know you're deep. So I used to use that as a gauge when I taught teams. Get your hand wet. Get your hand wet. The sooner your hand wet is wet, the deeper your blade is. And once they learn the feeling of the heaviness because the blade's deep, then I say, don't get your hand wet. They still, now they look for that feeling, but now they don't have that extra going on.
What about the placement of the bottom hand? Sorry to ask so many questions.
We talked about this yesterday at lunch because everybody does. Every clinic I've done in the world, somebody holds their paddle wrong, right? I use right where the blade ends here, put your fist, give it about a half inch, and goes there, it's usually between 5 and 6 inches.
Okay.
Any lower, too hard to get to the water.
Right.
Any higher, not enough leverage. So that's this right in here is that sweet spot.
Okay.
You go to the Olympic Training Center, you get a Greg Barton gold medalist, he gets a brand new kayak paddle, it comes in the mail. He never paddles it without putting a piece of tape here and a piece of tape here to tell himself where the hand goes.
Yeah.
And not like tight where you can not move your hand, you give yourself play.
Some room.
But you want to feel something. Oh, I'm too high. Like the paddles we do because his neck is longer, that's how I tell. It's like, I'm touching this, I'm too low. But why don't we do it? I always wondered that.
That's a good idea.
No, I do.
You want to put a little, build up a little tape here, build up a little tape there, you feel it, you know where it's at.
Do you recommend like grip on the blade, like when people
relaxed
grip?
Well, I think it's personal preference. Some people like a little bigger shaft, right? A little bit more there. Some people like it a little smaller. Too small to me on the paddle shaft, then your forearm gets tight when you hold.
Yeah.
But I think that's personal. I mean that, and this is coming from K1, like training center stuff. Some people would put grip on their paddles. Some people would just put a guide where their paddles went. Some people actually put a little lump there, you know, for the, because you're doing this rotation thing with the kayak. I always prefer just the shaft. It's just me. And you know what's nice is you guys are forward quick. You're forward quick enough, and it's not tense. That's good. It's really good.
See how I drop my top hand so low? Is that bad?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's because you're slipping and you're rolling your hand forward.
Okay. Because I can feel doing it, but I don't know how to stop it. I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
Do it in the trainer.
Okay.
Same thing, you have a good load. Your top hand was real slow. Like once you're in here, you have a lot of power and you're getting it from your opposite lat. Your issue is just, you know, that your timing is off.
I've always had issues with that.
All you gotta do is, as soon as you came out with the guy in front of you, your timing is gone. You can't, like, okay, I'm going in late. It's because you're coming out late, you know? You just get it out. Yeah. Okay. Your job is to be in and out with the person in front, no matter what. You have a little bit of pause in the front. You come up a little high. A little bit. Keep it a little lower in the front, probably. Timing in the water is very nice. So, who's in five? So, okay, so what's happening with you is you're pushing that top hand before you hit the water. So you're gonna see your blade is gonna come back pretty far before it goes deep, and the angle will probably be off. Right? See that hand roll forward?
Mm-hmm.
Now you're good. You wanna go and load there. So instead of doing this, forward quick is good. A little bit of pause in the front, but it's okay. It's not. It takes time to get all that. I don't know if I can see you. Your timing with one. I got out far enough. When you do engage, what I like, that's rare for me to say, when you do engage, you're engaging this lat. You can see this. When you're coming back before you meet too soon, but you're engaging. And you can actually see him this. It's good. Just gotta get it in front and not roll that, not that forward.
Mm.
For you, blade is in a good spot, but I'm pretty sure that you just roll it in the water on yours, right?
What do you mean roll it?
Yeah. Your blade, it's got to be slipping for your top hand to go down that quick.
Okay. It does feel slipping. I can feel the
slippage. So, like right here, you catch, and you don't really load, and right when you get here, you go like this.
That's when I load it.